forget all the wrongs and every reason why we've changed. And there's a storm inside my head. It's getting me in trouble, baby, and I can't break away.
You guys are ready for Innsbruck approach. However, today is going to be the easy approach, sadly. Well, I'm going to be approaching runway 8, but it's going to be just straight in. So we're not going to be doing the little horseshoe or the loop or anything like that to get into the runway. So still, we'll have some fun and we'll find Innsbruck. So we're going to do just one flight, just one leg tonight, tonight. And then we're going to go back into Midwest RP and we're going to do some Midwest RP streaming once again. So anyways, we're just going to get right on into the flight here. So we're flying the IXCG 737, Transavia, I think it's that, yeah, Transavia, and yeah, we're having some fun in Innsbruck. C. Montigny, hopefully I said your name correctly. Welcome to the stream. Yeah, you make, hopefully you're doing well. Alright, let's head into the cockpit. Let's go ahead and start getting everything started here. So we're here at Eindhoven. We're going to be going to, once again, Innsbruck. It's about an hour, 30-minute flight. It's not too bad. So let me go ahead and get the... fuel and everything generated here. Let me actually... So our flight... Our cruise altitude is going to be 330. 33,000 feet. Let's go ahead and generate the OFP now. Gonna get us our fuels and everything, and then we will get ready to head out. All right, so we are gonna be carrying 12,879 pounds of fuel. Let's go here. Let's go ground services. Go ahead and connect all the power there, and let's go ahead and get the battery turned on. Battery is on, and we'll go ahead and toss the ground power on. We'll get the galley power on. Go up here. We'll go ahead and get the nav set. There we go. Alright, clear that off. Let's go ahead and cut the music here. Wendell Veritzel, welcome to stream. Glad you can make it. Hope you're doing well. Nice detail. Yes, very nice. Very nice detail. Alright, so we're going to go down here and get our FMC set up. Let's get FMC positioned in it. Our reference airport is going to be EHEH, which is Eindhoven. Pop that there. We're going to bring that down. We're going to go to route. We're going to pop that back up there. And we're going to be going to Lowy, which is Innsbruck. We're not flying on Batsim tonight. There's no controllers on, so there's really no point in doing Batsim tonight. So we're just going to sit back, relax, and just enjoy. That's not what I wanted, but let's go to legs, departures and arrivals, departures. And we're going to be on the LNO 5 Kilo departure. And departing, is it runway 21 still? I think it's still runway 21. So we're going to be departing runway 21. If I could select it. Did it not select or did it select? Let's go to legs. Okay, maybe it did. I think it did. Alright, let's go activate that, execute it. Let's go departure, or let's go to route. And we're going to enter in a bunch of extra waypoints here. We're going to go to next page. We're going to enter in Lursu. I have no idea. Then we're going to be going on to an airway, Uniform Zulu 210. We'll pop that on that side there. Then we're going to be going on to Kilo Romeo Whiskey, which is point not on airway. 210, right? Uniform Zulu 210. Oh no! KRH. KR Hotel. There we go. Then we're going to be going on to Uniform Mike 150, so Uniform Mike 150 airway, and then we are going to be exiting the airway via Utaba, I don't know. Uniform Tango Alpha Golf Alpha. Oh no, Taba, not Tag. Whoops. Bravo Alpha. And we'll pop that in there. Then we're going to be on to another airway, which is going to be Uniform Lima 607. And we're going to pop that in the airway. And then we're going to be exiting via the arrival. So it's going to be X-Ray, Echo, Bravo, Echo. India, X-Ray. And then that's going to be our route. And then we're going to go to departures and arrivals. We're going to go to arrivals. And then we're going to be on the Zebix. I have no idea how to pronounce it. We're going to be on the 1 Bravo. Yeah, 1 Bravo. And then we're going to be on the localizer for runway 8. Into there, and then our approach or our transition is going to be LMEM. We're going to execute that. We're going to go to legs. We're going to make sure there's no discos and no vectors, and everything looks clear. So let's go back to page 1. Read the guys' chat here. I'm an aviation geek, aren't we all? Turns out there is 1.1 million more people who like it too. Enough to subscribe to my YouTube channel. What? Alright, so let's head on. Let's see what else we got. The camera seems now we're fine. Move it down a little bit. It's kind of a knowing when the bottom ones are almost cut off. Alright, so we got the FMC done there. Let's go here. Let's go to ground services. Go ahead and fuel up the aircraft. It's going to be what was the fuel again? It was like 12,000 something. 12,000, so 12 point, I'm going to round to 12.9. So 12.9 is what we'll round it to. Our zero fuel weight is going to be 100.4. So let's go and set that to 100.4. Oh, okay, 100.4. Alright, we'll instant load that, and our fuel stuff is all set down there. Go ahead and close out of that. And let's go back down here. Let's go ahead and go to index and performance page. We're going to set in our gross weight, which is going to be 113.3. We're going to pop that in there. It's going to do all that for us. Our plan, I'm going to
Well, first I'm going to set our cost index, which is 7. I'm actually going to change that to 80, just so we can go, just so we'll go a little faster. Our reserves, I'm just going to put 1.0. And then our plan, 11.9. Okay, that changes, alright, 12.9. Okay, there we go, that's good enough. Alright, so that's going to be all of that. Our cruise altitude is going to be 330, so 33,000 feet. We're going to pop that in there. We're going to execute that. We're going to go to N1 limit. We're going to set our flex to 45. We're going to go takeoff page. We're going to set flaps 5. Our trim is going to be 3.4. We're going to set our V-speeds, V1, VR, and then V2 is all set. So trim is going to be 3.4, so let's go and set that. About right there. And let's go to the legs page, and we are good to go on that. Let's go up here and go ahead and go over through our flow. So we're going to get the yaw damper on. We're going to go and get the first forward fuel pump on. We got the galley power going. We got the battery on. Standby power is all good to go. Got a ground power active. Those are off, which is good. We don't really need our panel lights on. Doesn't really do much since it's daytime. We're going to get our emergency exit lights on. We're going to go ahead and get our seatbelt signs on. We're going to go and get our window heats on. And everything's good to go on that. Let's go here. Let's go and get our packs onto auto. We'll get our APU bleed. Actually, keep that off. Keep those on. Alright, let's go ahead and set our flight altitude to our cruise altitude, which is 33,000 feet. So set that to 330. Right there. And then our landing altitude, which I'm going to go on Navigraph, the Navigraph charts real quick to grab that. Our landing altitude is going to be 1,907, sorry. Alright, so let's go and set that to 1, and then we're going to set this to 907, so 910, we'll round to 910. Alright, so right there, we're not going to worry about the cabin altitude. And other than that, that is good to go. Let's go ahead and grab our position lights on. Everything else checks in and is good to go. Let's go ahead and get our APU started. So let's hold this down for about 3 seconds, 2 and 3, and we'll release. And wait for the APU to start up. And while the APU is starting up, let's go and set up our autopilot settings here. So we're going to set this to 200 for the takeoff and departure. We're going to set our heading to runway heading, which I need to actually go back to the Eindhoven charts. And we're going to be taking off on runway 21. It's going to be heading of 214, so we're just going to go this way to 214. 214 set. Our altitude, we're just going to set to our cruise altitude of 33,000 feet. So right there. How long is real time for flight? This is going to be real time. So the amount of time it takes me to actually do this leg will take that amount of time in real life. So this will take, it's like an hour and 30 minute flight. So it's not too bad. It's pretty decent flight time. All right, let's go and get our APU buses on. And we're going to get the APU bleed on. We'll start hearing things come to life here. We're going to get our recirc fan on. I forgot about that. I'll turn that on. Alright, so we have that set. Let's go and get the altimeter as well, so we can set that. We have to also wait for our navs to align, which they are not aligned yet, but they probably will be here in a bit. Let's go to X-Enviro, let's go to Weather Briefing, and we're going to find EHEH. It's going to be QNH 1022, so 1022 is going to be our, it's already actually set, 1022, so it's good. So it's actually a 1 hour 30 minute flight. Yes, it actually is. Alright, there goes our navs there. So let's go down here and set that to our map. And let's go ahead and zoom out. And looks like our departure is good to go. So let's go and set that back to 10. So we don't need to worry about radios tonight. And other than that, we are good to go for everything there. It's going to keep that on auto. All right, so let's go and get the pre-plan. Pre-plan pushback. So we're going to be departing runway 21, which is going to be this runway here. So we'll push back tail to the right of plane orientation. So let's go to better pushback, pre-plan pushback, and we will push back tail to the right. And right there will be good.
Route to cockpit, plan acknowledged. Call me through the menu when you are ready.
All right, so we are almost ready. Let's go ahead and head on up here. And let's go and get our electrics on. And let's go ahead and call them and tell them that we're ready for pushback. So let's go and start pushback. So it's going to freeze up for a little bit here.
Ground to cockpit. Tow is driving up.
I'm going to have to learn. I'm trash at this game. Got any tips? Really, just learn the plane. That's pretty much it. Just fly a plane. You know, stick to one plane. Don't hop to a bunch of other planes. If you hop a bunch to other planes and you're just learning, it's going to get really confusing for you. So I learned in 737. That's why I could fly this plane. And I could set everything up without going through checklists. Because I learned this plane back in like my Flight Simulator X days and brought all that over to X-Plane here. So, it's just really just stick with one plane while you're learning. And then once you're efficient in that plane, once you got it down where you don't need checklists, then you can fly a whole route without a checklist, which, you know, in reality would be the safest thing. But once you know how to set everything up and get off the ground and then land, pretty much at that point in time, you're pretty much ready to, you know, move on to another plane. So just stick with one plane, learn that plane. Once you learn it, you know, go to the next plane, learn that plane, go to the next, and that's really it. Just small stepping stones. Don't hop back and forth, because then you're not going to learn anything. You're going to get planes confused. You're going to get planes mixed up. And even though I fly flight sims quite a bit, I still do that. Like, for example, with the MD-80, I do that a lot with the MD-80. The MD-80 is a plane that is hard for me to learn because everything's scattered all over the place. So, hopefully that helps you out. That's pretty much about all I can give you. Video tutorials are going to help you out a lot. I'm just going to release the park brake form. Let's go ahead and turn the packs off for engine starts.
And you may start engines.
But yeah, that's pretty much it. Just take your time. That's pretty much it. Let's go ahead and start the right engine first. And the right engine is now coming alive. We'll watch the N2. Once the N2 reaches 25% N2, that's when we'll start the engine. So we'll listen to the engine starting up here. There we go. Alright, it's already past 25%. I forgot how fast these engines kind of start up. Start up quite fast. Alright, we're going to start engine number one.
Operation complete. Set parking brake.
Alright.
Connecting tow. Stand by.
There's 25%. Introduce the fuel. change the view a little bit here.
Tow is disconnected and bypass pin has been removed. Hand signal will be on the right. We'll see you next time and have a great flight.
I forgot to turn on my anti-collision light for the pushback, but that's alright. That is alright. Alright, so wait for him to give us a thumbs up on the right side. Let's go and set our flaps to 5 degrees for takeoff. And 5 is set. Alright, there's thumbs up. Our flaps are in transit as of now, so wait for those to get set up. And we will get ready to get out of here. So, see, the APU will be coming off here momentarily. Let's go and get the packs back on. And all the stuff is good. APU is off. Let's go ahead and turn these over to continuous. Our flaps are still, flaps should be good now actually. All right, let's go and do some checks. So we'll go full right. Oh, is my joystick not plugged in? Did I unplug it by accident? Maybe I unplugged it by accident. Let me check. I think my joystick got unplugged by accident. Let me check. No, it's plugged in. I don't know why it's not working though. Let me check the controls. I accidentally turned my TV on, whoops. Let's go here. Go joystick. Sidewinder joystick. Okay. Nothing is working. Uh-oh. Okay, well that's working. Okay, the buttons are working, but for some odd reason, the roll and everything is not working. Let me calibrate real quick. Okay, throttles are working. For some reason, my yoke control is not working though. Uh-oh. This might be a problem. Oh wait, is it because my Xbox controller was plugged in? Oh, well, there we go. I figured out. All right, let's go full right. Check. Full left. Check. Full back. Forward. Can't really see that. Full back. Check, full forward check, there we go, right rudder, left rudder, everything looks good. Alright, cool, there we go, I fixed it. It's because my control is plugged in, whoops. Alright, let's go get our taxi lights on, get our runway turnoff lights on. And let's head to the taxi, or to the runway. My mistake. Turn that off. Alright, so we'll do our before takeoff checklist. I'm gonna hold it right there. Alright, so got our lights on, gonna get our strobe lights on. Runway should be clear, let's go ahead and pull out onto the runway. Everything checks in. We're not gonna worry about the duct overheat. Let's just ignore that. We got that. Let's go and get our landing lights on. Go and get our wing lights on. Got our autopilot set up down here. Alright, everything's checking in.
Approaching 2-1. On runway 2-1.
Let's go ahead and just make sure everything's good to go. We got auto brake RTO is good. All that stuff is good. We got our auto throttle armed and ready to go. Release the brakes. Power up. Engines are stable. Release the brakes. Get to our toga button here. Press toga button. And we'll start the clock. Oh, I forgot how sensitive this plane is with the nose wheel steering. Alright, watch for our V-speeds. Alright, V1, rotate. Used to flying this plane again. Alright, positive rate gear coming up. Trim the aircraft here. Alright, we'll hand fly for a little bit. There's a lot of dead zone. What is that all about? Hold on, I got like a massive dead zone for some reason. Which is weird because not showing it there. Yeah, there is a massive dead zone right there. Hold on. I need to fix that. Where's the dead zone at though? No, I don't want to choose that. I don't know, maybe it's not. Need to recalibrate. Do I need to oh my god. Alright, let's try this again. Okay, just make sure that all of this is good to go. Okay, is it better? There we go. That dead zone's gone now. Alright, I'm gonna make a left-hand turn. Gonna start getting our flaps up. Gonna turn on VNAV. Control our speeds for us. Keep on progressively bringing our flaps up.
Altimeter setting.
Alright, flaps zero. And we're going to set LNAV, and we'll have autopilot do the rest. So let's go and set our gear to the, to the off position. Let's just make sure our gear didn't come down. Good. Alright, let's go and set altimeter settings back to standard. There we go. Alright, we are up. There's Eindhoven there. So we have VNAV and LNAV enabled. I'm gonna let my dog out before he starts barking. So, get some like wing views and whatnot, get some, let's see, let's go ahead and get the sounds turned down a little bit. Some of the sounds are really quiet. And maybe it's always been that way. Alright. Coming up towards 10,000 feet, let's go ahead and shut the lights off. Get some music going as well. Okay, let's see. Oh, Hero Board is uploading again, nice. Thank you. out of the photo reel. That's kind of loud. Yeah, we got new followers. Gonna check out who that is. ADB2100, thank you for the follow. Very much appreciated. Glad you're enjoying. This isn't the camera view that I want. What is this camera view? No, I don't want to cancel. God dang it. Alright, there we go. Alright, let's try it out. There we go. And I think we're back in the photo reel already? Yeah, photo reel, yep. There's a pretty nice patrol going on, or getting started right now. I'm gonna check the Innsbruck approach stuff real quick. Alright, top of climb is coming up. Somebody's making a Texan too. Jays, welcome to the stream. Hopefully I said your name, hopefully I pronounced it correctly. reaching the end of the photo reel. Anything interesting on explain.org downloads page? You know what plane I have to fly one of these days is the DC-3. There's a freeware DC-3 that looks really, really good. We're gonna have to take that out for a spin probably sometime soon.
Let's see where we are at. We're 6 nautical miles out from our top of ascent. Damn, that's a good scenery.
To fly to Lugano sometime, or how do you pronounce that airport? Go ahead and check out where we are at. So we are just at 80 nautical miles out from our top of descent. Some frame lag for some reason. Come back into the photo reel. Thank you. What was my GPU? It's a GTX 1070 for the Win Edition. Alright, we are 40 nautical miles out from our top of descent. Entering a weird set of photo reel here. For some reason it's all out of... that's weird. That's snow. Looks like snow to me. Pretty sure that is snow. And this is with max performance settings? No. No. That would completely break, completely lag my game. But these are my settings here. Got visual effects on high, texture quality on high, which I could probably boost that up. Anti-aliasing I have on two times. And then number of world objects high, and then reflection detail, I have that turned up because don't really need it. I don't really mind the reflection detail, so. And it used to lag me, but I think now it's fine, but I just haven't changed the settings back yet. Settings is really good. Yeah, the only thing is like I try to go with optimal, you know, the best frames for stream, because when I stream my frames kind of go down anyways, but it's When not streaming, my frames are a little better, so... yeah. Here's our top descent here. Yeah, a little bit past it, but that's all right. Just like, let's see. It's a little bit much. To be there by 24,000 feet. Exhibit, I don't know. We're gonna reach that by 13,000 feet, see if we can actually reach that. Oh, probably not. Probably not. That's alright, if we need to, we can hold. We can do a right 360 at Bemke? Bemke, yeah. I'm gonna go and cut the music here. Yeah, we're gonna make a right 360 here, so let me just go and turn on heading mode. We're gonna make a right 360 to make sure that we meet our required descent rate. There we go, perfect. Back on track here, let's go ahead. Alright. This, getting back on track. Let's see, LMM is going to be at 13,000 as well, so I probably could have kept going, that's alright. And bring our speed back 250 knots. UNH is going to be 1021 or 1021. We're going to go on heading mode here. Alright, so I've never done this approach before, so I have no idea what to expect here. I don't know, there's not even any altitude restrictions at all. I'm gonna go into a right 360 again. I don't know if we're gonna be able to make it if we keep going. I really like this though, it's pretty cool. You just go around like that, it's pretty damn awesome. The weird thing is, there's no altitude given, so I don't know. It's a weird one. gonna start bringing our flaps down two notches here. And we'll go around this mountain here. And we'll maintain 7,000 feet as well. Or 7,000, we'll maintain 7,500 feet. Really close to the mountains here. There's our airport right there. view's all messed up. Just gonna toss the gear. I'll bring our flaps down. Gear down, three green, lights are good, auto brake is set. We're gonna go and take control of the aircraft. Alright, our aircraft. I'm bringing our flaps down. Start bringing our speed back. All right, flaps going full. Speed brake is armed. Gonna increase our speed here. Hopefully we'll make a good landing out of this. Okay, we got one red, three white, so we're a little bit high, but that's alright. There we go, two red, two white.
Approaching 08.
Hundred. on.
Continue.
Feet remaining.
All right, 178 feet per minute and 1.4 G's in the landing. Not bad, not bad at all. A little off center line, but that's all right. All right, there's 70 knots, manual braking. All right, and we are at Innsbruck, safe and sound. Alright, I'm gonna slow up here. And then we'll clear off the runway and we will be done with the flight sim stream. So watch, of course, watch the replay back, so we'll do that. Alright, let's go and clean up the flaps. Goes all the way to zero. Go and put in the speed brakes. And let's taxi to the ramp.
On runway 26.
Let's take this ramp right there. There's no auto gate here, so we have to guide ourselves in. Right there will do. Alright, let's pull the park brake. Park brake is pulled. And we have arrived.
Safe. And sound. So,
got the park brake pulled. We are here in Innsbruck, and we are going to watch the replay back, see how smooth our landing was, and then we'll call it there, and then we'll go hop on Midwest RP to stream there. There's actually patrol. There's only like one civ on, so we might do it later, but we'll see what the patrol is like early or later. Alright, let's go to flight, let's go to toggle replay mode, and we're going to watch a replay back of that landing. Oh yeah, not bad, not bad. Nice firm landing, I'd say. Yeah, I'd say a nice firm landing that was. suck. It's kind of rough. That was probably kind of rough, but it wasn't bad. From the cockpit, it seemed like it was much smoother. Yeah. Definitely not my best landing in Innsbruck, but definitely not my worst. Definitely not my worst. Hey, where do we touch down at? Not bad, still within the markers. Not bad at all. I'll watch from this side here. Yeah, not bad. I'll take it. Alright guys, so that's going to be the stream for tonight, or for the, that's going to be the explained stream. I'm going to do Midwest, hopefully if the patrol kicks up, which most likely it does pretty soon, so we'll go ahead and join in on that when that kicks off, when it gets more people. So other than that guys, hope you guys enjoyed tonight's Flight Sim stream. We'll be back with the province to province. God, hopefully this weekend, hopefully on Sunday or whatever. I don't know, depends, because on this weekend I'm actually going to be out. I'm going to be staying at the Eliesca Resort, so we'll see where that goes. But other than that, guys, hope you guys enjoyed. Hope you guys have a great rest of your night, and as always, I'll see you guys in the next one.
Trouble, baby, and I can't breathe.